This is Alec. He's testing one of the most advanced bionic limbs on the planet.
This bionic power leg is completely different than anything out there. You walk on it and you're like, wow, this is gonna make a difference for everybody.
Rather than having Alec control the device with his mind, this prosthetic uses artificial intelligence to control itself.
These devices have achieved things that before we thought was impossible. The field is evolving really quickly, and a lot of the things that we see in the movies will become reality.
Amplified humans is going to be a thing. And the fact that I get to see all of that before it happens, it's magical. I love coaching. Football is great because it correlates to life so well. You're gonna battle through adversity. It's about how you use that to help yourself grow and move forward. In 2013, I was working with my cousin and my uncle building houses. I was just heading to work. It was cold here in Utah, and I knew that the roads were gonna be a little icy. Ended up going up the canyon right by my cousin, and he wrecked about halfway up. So I got out to help him and make sure he was okay, and another truck hit me doing about 85, 90 miles an hour. I should have died. I should have died multiple times. I should have died from the terror in my heart. The infection in my leg should have killed me, and it didn't. But when you have been through something so traumatic and lost a limb and literally a piece of you, then you know, like, I have to have some sort of purpose here.
How are you? It's been a minute, yeah?
Yeah.
How's life?
Pretty good.
Good?
Yeah.
Good. How do you feel like your knee strength is? That knee?
This knee?
Yeah.
I feel like it's really weak.
Really weak? Okay. That's still normal. I mean, you're still early on, and that's an issue that we're gonna work with for sure.
I really enjoy talking with patients and helping them to walk. With my leg, I relate to them in a different way.
Today, Alec is working in the lab of Dr. Tommaso Lenzi to develop a new type of bionic prosthesis.
So Alec was the first person to test our bionic leg. He's way more than just a subject, he's like a collaborator. Our test today is to compare the performance of a bionic leg with a conventional prosthesis. We're looking into agility, turning, climbing two steps at a time, things that no one thought was going to be possible to do with a bionic leg.
With conventional prosthetics, amputees have to go upstairs one at a time, leading with their good leg. Powered prosthesis changes that.
It takes a lot of effort to go up two steps at a time. And so to have the robot be able to perform that movement is a big deal.
I'm pretty happy with this.
For the first time ever, Dr. Lenzi's team performed a new test on the leg. They took it outside the lab and into the real world.
I mean, yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
That
was funny right there.
Yeah.
It's great. And then seeing like going up five stairs like that, it's pretty amazing. The way we win at this game is by taking an approach that's completely different than our biological leg. The most common way to think about a bionic prosthesis is as a tool that receives inputs and performs movements. The challenge with this approach is that it requires a lot of attention from the user. So we decided to give a brain to the bionic leg to kind of match the behavior of the user.
It is very different. Instead of like straight swinging, like on a hinge all the time, it really is up and over.
Dr. Lenzi's theory is that this way of using a powered prosthetic will feel more effortless than controlling it consciously, making it easier for amputees to adopt powered prosthesis.
We've got an amputee coming in to walk on a robot, and that kind of sounds crazy when you put it in those words. Someone's gonna come in and put their weight on it, and you have to believe 100% in the work that you've done.
something big is coming down the pipe. Able-bodied little kids that come up to me right now and they're looking at me like that leg is a little different. Like in 10 years, they're gonna come up to me and they're gonna say, I want that leg. I wanna be able to do the things that you can do on that leg.
I feel very optimistic of what bionics can do for people because I've seen how much it has evolved in the last 10 years. I believe that we are the generation that will see physical disability disappear.
My job is to give people hope. I am a literal example. Like, yeah, hard things are gonna happen, but let's use those things to grow and move ourselves forward.
Thanks for watching this episode of Superhuman. If you liked the video, subscribe to our channel for more Superhuman episodes. And don't forget to visit freethink.com for more stories of people moving the world.